Hey, good evening. Here we are to enjoy communion together, to celebrate the, what Jesus has done for us, to celebrate the love of God that is absolutely true and guaranteed and gives us so much hope. And so we're going to worship a bit and then we're going to enjoy communion together.
Spirit is the light into your presence. Like a child, we come running through the halls of heaven to the Holy of Holies. Doors are blown wide open, joy is overflowing, the halls of heaven. We come running, we come running. To behold, I get caught up, I get caught up, I get caught up. Like a child we come running through the halls of heaven to the Holy of Holies. Doors are blown wide open, joy is overflowing, the halls of heaven.
Rely on you, and that we don't have to rely on our own strength, because you've already defeated everything for us, and that we can rely on you for all the things that we worry about and all the things that are going on around us.
Face to face with the glory of God, and heart to heart with the one that we love. Face to face with the glory of God, and heart to heart with the one that we love. Oh, face to face with the glory of God, and heart to heart with the one that we love. Like a child we come running through the halls of heaven to the Holy of Holies. Doors are blown wide open,
halls of heaven.
You know, it's so exciting that as we come around to communion, you know, God had a plan and he had his rescue mission plan. And we remember tonight what he's done. And because he planned and he put these things into practice and brought them to pass, we are where we are today. And, you know, we can take encouragement that God always has a plan. Yeah. And God has a plan and a hope and a future for each one of us. And it's really important that we don't let our circumstances dictate our state of mind at this time and therefore our lives. But, you know, because it's so easy to give into anxiety and worry and fear as it's all about us in the world. But, you know, God does have a plan and he has a hope and a future for each one of us.
Yeah.
And even though these other things that might be dominating the world in which we live, you know, God has a plan of peace and of hope and of a future and a way through, and he will part the waters for you. You know, in the Old Testament, there's a story of Joseph, and in the days of a great famine, and God had a plan and a strategy, and he took care of Joseph. You know, he didn't change all the circumstances, but he took care of Joseph and his family because of Joseph, many others and Joseph's family were safely taken care of because God has a plan.
Mm-hmm.
God always has a plan. And as we gather for communion tonight, God has a plan today to give you a hope and a future, and a hope and a future for you and I. And the emblems remind us of God's continually saving grace. His saving grace is the same yesterday and today and forever. And his saving grace is there in great power to meet us at our point of need. So, you know, just as let us have that same spirit that Joseph had and Esther had, in that they didn't give in to the anxious thoughts and the worries and the concerns of their day, but they kept their eyes focused, knowing that God had a plan, and God has a plan for you. And let us stay focused and know that he has a plan for us and a purpose and a safe way through all that is around your life at this time, and he will bring you safely through.
Amen. Well, we'll take the emblem, the biscuit or whatever it is that you're using, and let's use that as a symbol of the broken body of Jesus that was broken for our healing, our health, and let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you had a plan that was going to affect us for our life on earth. Thank you that it's a plan that's perfect and complete, and that it came because Jesus came in the flesh amongst us, was one of us and lived amongst us. And we are honoring you tonight as a Father who we can trust and who we can love, because we know your love for us. And we honor Jesus, who died an incredibly agonizing death on our behalf, whose body was absolutely wounded and bashed and bruised, and by his stripes we can be healed. And we, Lord, thank you for this plan. We honor you for your goodness, and we bless you as we praise you and honor you with this communion celebration. Amen? Amen. Let's eat together. And we take a cup of something as a reminder, as a symbol of the blood. And let's pray into that too. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you put in a plan that had perfect and complete eternal life and salvation that spoke at all times, that the blood of Christ is on the mercy seat of heaven and is still there, is still as powerful, as complete, as all-consuming in terms of its impact as it ever was. And we honor you and we bless you and we praise you for your goodness to us. Amen. Amen. Let's drink together.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. You know, the A-team, they used to say, the colonel used to say, I love it when a plan comes together. We are living in the power of God's plan, and there is a plan that works, and there's a plan that is available to you and me. And the best thing to do is just simply open our hearts and walk in love and obedience to Him to the best of our ability, and His plan will work out, and we're going to make it in Jesus' name. God bless. Have a great week.
Here and now, making loud at the top of our lungs. There's a sound breaking now, Lord, for all that You've done. And now we're turning our hearts to You. And I will never stop loving You. This will be the best time of our lives as we count Your love. Here we are to collide with Your love. Every heart set apart just to be where You are. And now we're turning our hearts to You. And oh, we'll never stop loving. This is our moment to lift Your name. This is our time. This is our